I've been a Platinum Games fan since the moment that I played Metal Gear Rising. The cutscenes and fighting mechanics in that game were just amazing, and from that point on I decided that I wanted to play all the games that Platinum had put out to that point. Only problem was that I only owned a PC. So I was always on the lookout for a cheap PlayStation 3 so I could finally play the Platinum other games. But I never got one. And then they released Bayonetta out of nowhere on PC. So that was an instant buy for me. But the game that I really wanted to come out on PC was Vanquish. It just always looked very cool to me, and I never saw much gameplay of it, but just the style alone reminded me a lot of Metal Gear Rising, so I thought I would surely like it, although it is a different genre. And then, a month after Bayonetta, Vanquish finally came out. And man, am I disappointed. So Vanquish is a third-person cover-based shooter, with the added mechanic that you can slow down time when you make a certain move, and it works great. It is different than other cover-based shooters because of this, and also gives you more control of the fast-paced action. Another thing that makes this game a little different than other shooters is the gun upgrade system. You can either pick up the same weapon a couple of times in a row, or pick up an upgrade point to upgrade your guns. It's a little confusing at first, but you figure it out soon enough. So at first I really liked the gameplay, and when I came to the first boss, it looked very impressive and it was actually quite hard to defeat. Boss fights as a whole are very impressive in this game, with one exception, but more on that later. So I continued on playing and I expected some downtime like you would normally see in a game like this, but it never came. The game just continued at full pace the moment you opened the door to leave the boss area. And that was the moment this game started to lose me, because there is just no downtime in this game at all. You keep shooting everything for 4.5 hours straight. You do the same things over and over again, and there's nothing to mix things up enough to keep you of being interested. They do have some sections where it's a little different than normal, like a dark tunnel or a sniper section, but they only last for a very short while and aren't long enough to make the normal combat feel less monotonous. What doesn't help much is that the surroundings, while impressive at first, look the samey apart from a section in the woods, but the rest all use the same color palette. But luckily at the end of every act there was always a cool boss fight to keep me going, except the last one. The final boss fight is one of the most boring and easy ones of the whole game. Instead of fighting giant robots, you fight two small ones. And they aren't even all that powerful. I beat them without dying once, with a starting loadout, so not even upgraded weapons. So after beating them for the first time, I expected the game to continue, because it didn't feel like a final boss. But no, soon enough the credits rolled. And the worst part about it? The story wasn't wrapped up at all. The story started really strong with a very cool opening cinematic. Basically, a spaceship was taken over by the Russians and it destroyed San Francisco. But while you are playing the game, the story beats are very predictable. Even the one who betrays you, you recognize the moment you see him. But basically, you are just attacking the spaceship through the whole game, and at the end it turns out that the enemy wasn't even on that spaceship, but somewhere else. He said continue with phase 2 and that's it. No conclusion or closure at all. So after you have beaten the main game, there are also challenges, which are basically horde mode. Cool if you really like the main mechanics and can't get enough, but I didn't really care for them because I was sick of the main game already. So in the end, I am hugely disappointed by this game. Don't get me wrong, it is not a bad game. It just isn't the great game that I hoped it would be. So I can't give this game anything higher than a 5. Hopefully I like Bayonetta more. Thanks for watching and see you next time.